Hi, friends, and welcome to Game Day Eve from GoJacks.com. Alongside Mike Strzok, Tyler Merriam, the South Dakota State football team will play in the Hall of Fame game tomorrow night, hosting Southern Illinois. We'll talk about that in a moment. Let's begin with Youngstown State briefly. Hard to win a football game when the other team has the ball 45 minutes.
Yeah, that's very tough when you're just not able to get your offense on the field to, you know, pick up some first downs, put some points on the board, and then your defense has spent so much time and they just get wore down. Really, really hard to win a ball game when the time of possession is so much in favor of one team.
I thought the biggest positive on any side of the football for South Dakota State was the way the offensive line played, particularly in pass protection. This is a Youngstown State defensive front we had talked about that was among the best in the nation in sacks, and Taryn Christian's feet were kept clean.
Yeah, that offensive line did do a nice job of giving Christian time to look over his options. We thought going into the game that Youngstown had probably the best defensive line we had seen to date, and that offensive line really responded well in pass protection.
Well, the 8th-ranked Jackrabbits back at it after that 19-7 loss last Saturday. They'll host Southern Illinois this Saturday. Let's discuss the Salukis a little bit. We'll begin with the offensive side of the ball and the fact that they average 40 passes a game, and yet they've only been sacked once. Part of that's the O-line. Part of that is the offensive philosophy.
Well, and I think with their offensive philosophy, they want to spread you out. They start out in shotgun, and pretty much everything they do is short passing game, get the ball out quickly, and get it to the outside and let their wide receivers, who there's a number of guys that can make plays out there, just get in the ball into their hands quickly and let them make the plays.
Salukis are 2-2, could easily be 3-1, lost by 7 to Northern Iowa last week, and three times came up empty inside the red zone. Sam Straub, their quarterback, 12 touchdowns to 4 interceptions, throwing for better than 250 yards a game. Very strong arm on this young man.
He can toss it around. What they ask of him within their offense is to make quick decisions, and he does a nice job of doing that. He's not one that's going to sit back there in the pocket for 3, 4, 5 seconds. It's catch the ball, make a read, and unleash that ball and get it out as quickly as possible. So part of the reason why they don't have a lot of sacks is he does a nice job of releasing it quickly, but he also knows if the options aren't there, then he throws it away.
This is a very athletic offensive unit as far as the skill positions are concerned. Daquan Isom, a career high over 150 rushing yards against Northern Iowa last week. Two young men who have passed 1,000 career receiving yards. Again, athletic at all those skill spots.
They do have a lot of athleticism at the skill spots. Those guys they got a lot of juice. They can move. They'll make plays and they're shifty, and it's difficult to get clean hits on those guys. And so you really need a lot of guys rallying to the ball. First guy needs to make them change direction, get some cloth, and then the other guys to wrap up.
And again, we anticipate a lot of points when you consider SDSU was the highest scoring offense in the Valley last year. Southern Illinois had the most total yards per game in the Valley. We shift to the defensive side of the ball. This is a young front that Southern Illinois will have. When you look at their two deep, two true freshmen, three red shirts, a couple of sophomores, and a JUCO transfer, and they have 12 sacks through four games.
Well, their youth kind of reminds you a lot of the SDSU defensive line in that very similar, playing a lot of younger guys, true freshmen, redshirt freshmen, but they get after it. Very aggressive defense up front, do a lot of twists, bring some guys off the edge, and so the offensive line will have their hands full as being able to recognize what they're doing and being able to slide protection to the appropriate places.
When you get into a month of October in college football and you have a situation where you have a team averaging less than 100 rushing yards per game allowed, that jumps off the page. They're averaging 99 per game. Some physical defenders at linebackers, and they're also very strong at the safety position.
Well, and that's a sign of a good defense in that they're sound and they're not giving up big plays in the run game, and that they have some reliable corners on the outside that they can cheat those safeties down and allow them to run downhill and make plays at the line of scrimmage in the run game.
We talk so much about special teams. It will be a big factor on Saturday. Southern Illinois is second nationally in net punting. They're seventh nationally in kickoff return average. That third side of the game of football will be very important tomorrow night.
Well, as we saw out in Montana against Montana State, how the special teams won the game for SDSU. Likewise, special teams have been very favorable to Southern Illinois and keeping them in games and allowing them to get good field position as well as pin opponents deep in territory. So, as always, special teams is that third phase of the game, and the Salukis have a very stout special team squad.
It's Hall of Fame weekend, and at halftime, all of the Hall of Fame enshrinees will be honored, including Josh Ronick, a young man who for a year was a teammate of yours and overcame that to become the greatest rusher yardage-wise in South Dakota State football history. In the CFL, they called him the Little Ball of Hate, and he was a load for the Jackrabbits in that backfield.
Yeah, Ronick may not have been real tall had a lot to weight to carry, but boy, that kid, he ran hard, and his work ethic was just unbelievable. He came every day to practice with true attitude of trying to get better, and you know, the results speak for itself. He did what he was supposed to do. He took care of his body, and great career at SDSU.
3-1 South Dakota State. The Jacks are number 8 in the country as they host 2-2 Southern Illinois tomorrow night in the Hall of Fame game. 6 o'clock is the kickoff. Call 688-5422 or visit jackrabbittickets.com to join us tomorrow night.